A word from Jesus is all you need to breathe again, to live again. Chains are broken, God is revealed, raising leaders to transform the world.
Dominion City, the place to be.
average person before he gets married has dated 17 ladies. I'm sure about how many of you do this. You have your record. Some 21, some 27. You know that there are more believers, it's massive. It's alarming. The amount of boyfriends, the amount of dear friends, before the man finally settles down. Amen. Like the woman of Samaria that had five husbands, their home was husband, five husbands and one boyfriend. Six. That's why he couldn't reach women, only rich men. When Jesus touched her, the Bible says she went to the men. Because all the women were angry with her. We are still looking for one husband. We have collected five. And the sixth one, a boyfriend. Hallelujah. And this is the issue. It's a major issue. You know, the truth is that a lot of people who are not married today, now they are some people. The reason why they are not married is that men are not coming. Amen. But a lot of other people, the reason why they are not married is that their relationships not last. A lot of people have broken their hearts. Is it true? A lot of heartbreakers. And I'm visiting the house so far in the church. Am I complicating? Okay. So I want to talk to you this morning on principles for Lasting relationships. I am about 15, but I'll see what I can cover. So what I'll be doing on Sunday, I will teach. On Tuesday, I'll do an interactive question and answer, because I have a lot of questions. But if I still have time, I will show what to do. Hallelujah. Are you still here? So I want to show you principles. Because there are things that if you know, there are things that if you do, there are things that if you practice, you'll be able to at least get your relationship to where God wants you to get to. God wants you to get to the altar. And why I'm sharing this thing is that it doesn't, you know, it might not eradicate heartbreaks from the person, but it will minimize it. Am I complicated? It will minimize it. So, number one, as I start today, you know, before I give you number one, in order to put these principles to work, you must not be desperate about marriage. Once you're desperate about marriage, you will violate principles. So that is part of what we'll find today. A lot of single people, especially single ladies, are desperate about marriage. And the problem with desperation, the Bible says the violent take it by force. So when you're desperate, it will take it by force. Anybody you see, you take. Am I complicated? You know, somebody told me, if God does not give me a husband by the end of this year, anybody I see, I'll marry. Anybody I see, I'll marry. Okay, so that's what desperation. You know, and let me also say this, a lot of people who are married are wishing they are single. Maybe they are not here. But I'm telling you people, a lot of people who are married are wishing they are single. There are people who are single. I feel that not being married is a crime. And it's not. Amen. It's better to be single and be happy than to be married and be here. That's all I want to say. Yeah, it's true that two are better than one, but two can also be worse than one. So it's better to be one and know that it's just your life, the control of your life, than to fall into the hands of your president. I was just a man of sin, and he was teaching that, you know, it's not who you marry that makes your marriage successful, and it's what you do in the marriage. what percentage gets to the altar? Some guys say 1%. All you need to do is look around. You know, those are your friends on campus. They are babes. Have they become their wives? Babes don't become babes. Don't become wives.
Thank you.
Please.
Thank you.
a guy, you propose to the lady, and she doesn't want to respond to the proposal, but she wants.
Amen.
Somebody else. 18. Is it not 20? Try, verse 16. He said, go and tell him. Go and tell him. Stop banging the phone. Or you just call the phone. Moreover, if thy brother or your fiance or your fiancée or your wife or your husband shall trespass against thee, go. Tell somebody, go. 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 Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. Blessed are the troublemakers, for they shall be called sons of Satan. Ask somebody, are you a peacemaker? Are you a troublemaker? Which one are you? So we have decided to be a peacemaker. Something happens, I seek in consideration. We don't just see that. Say sorry when he's weak. Do you know, according to the Bible, you're supposed to apologize to the truth? That's right, an example. One is missing in the house. You accuse one of your kids that is the one that stole the money. Flogging. This guy, the little guy behind the money. That is the money that was lost. The time of the you were hiding. He said, no, that you cannot say that he's gone.
Did you observe what that is?
How I know that it's God that wrote this Bible is that the Bible does not say God, but it doesn't even need to come. If it's a father that wrote it, you will see fathers to go not your children. If it's a husband that wrote it, you will see husband not your wife. If it's a wife, the good wife submit to your husband. So there are instructions for bosses, for servants, for fathers, for there are instructions for pastors. An example, they call the brethren the God of the flock, you should take care of your pastor. There are instructions for pastors. You should take care of the flock. You are not feeding the flock.
This is not true.
Don't cover your flock. Except for the king.
Imagine this is not true.
Am I complicating it?
Oh, it's...
It will be not part of the
pastor. I was talking to somebody else. Yeah. He wanted to get married to this lady. In an alternative feast. And they stayed like that for more than 2 years. But the problem was that in those 2 years, it's causing a lot of pressure. You know, your father did this one, your mother did this one, And I told you one day, I said, you could have destroyed this relationship. You're destroying it. It's not what you're going to that is destroying it. It's how you're responding to it. I said, what brought two of you together? You know, it's love. Keep you being your love. Wow, jeez, wow, play. Say romantic text. Say you have fun. Amen. And they stopped doing that. And anytime they did, they got to the point they were quarreling every day. Every day they did, they still won. They got to come by, they pass on, and they might be more. They got to come by, they might be more. What is all that? And finally, after 2 years, the parents of the girl agreed for them to marry. But the guy refused to marry. This one, what was holding the marriage? The parents of the girl. Now the man has finally agreed. Oh, yeah, boss, now this is what he wanted for the last 2 years. Oh, yeah, do. He said he's not doing it. Because by then they had grown apart. Everything was about issue. Hey, if your relationship will work, you must learn to overlook issues.
Happy are they?
So if you don't endure, you will be happy. So if you don't do the relationship, watching, you can't go back to mind. Learn to overlook things. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
Yes, somebody, learn to overlook things.
Amen.
So that you can enjoy life. Then life is designed to be enjoyed. It's not designed to be endured. Let me see if I can touch two more very fast. And I'll tell it all. I don't know whichever number. But I'll
mention.
Be wise in dealing with parents.
This is another
young man. This is where I got a lot of
young man. That's why you don't want to commit to any of the
parents. Get to the huddle of parents. Understand your parents, understand their psychology, and know how to take advantage of it. You know from the one they will react to somebody for help. You don't bring the person from the one. Say, daddy. This is the girl. He said, from where? He said, answer, they say, Yare. Yare, from where? He said, from Zamfara. He said, Zamfara? Want to marry my son? No.
Put her food down.
great things. He told me that he's nice, and I've seen it for myself. But he also told me that he's a liar. I'll try to use the Bible to counter it. That people who serve God, should look at this and say, "You use me." People that see what they have said. Praise the Lord. But Pastor Lord is the kind of man he is, stood his ground, and he kept coming, we are trying to appeal to my God, we are praying, showing sleep, doing everything. I want to be successful for my sister, and for glory, to say, I'm accepted, people can go after. And today, my man, she's just happy, and he has not died. And he will not die. I'm trying to show you. But if you didn't stand his ground, if he couldn't wait for 2 years for somebody he loved, now he can marry somebody else. And who knows? That's all for the real men stand. Real men stand. Real men stand. Now, sometimes we are issues. An example is Joseph. Joseph was dating a young girl. And somewhere along the line, they were engaged to get married, only for him to realize that this girl was pregnant. And he goes to talk to the girl, "I've never touched you, I've never slept with you. How can you be pregnant?" And the girl said, "It's the Holy Ghost." And prior to that time, Holy Ghost had never impregnated anyone. Never. Only God knows what Mary went through. In the history of man, from Adam, the Holy Ghost has never got anybody pregnant. Imagine you have a girlfriend. If he has a one to man, he is here. He says the Holy Ghost. You will even be very angry. After you have done this, you have the audacity to claim that it's the Holy Ghost, that we cannot see to verify. This is the one. Joseph, being a good man, being a devoted man, decided he's going to put in a good fire. But you know what some people will do? They will cast him for a moment. For one of my friends, as she's very loose, he's sleeping around, after she will claim it's the Holy Ghost. Let me go say this. If you must end a relationship, it must be of something very serious. And when you end it, you should not expose the person. How can you expose somebody you have loved for 1 year? Somebody you have loved for 6 months? Somebody you have loved for 3 years? You now be carrying her name everywhere. You now be carrying his name everywhere. It's not right. It's not right. It's not right. If you don't mind the person, it should be between two of you. You should not be carrying the person's name about. That's the kind of man that Joseph was.
So that I can see and the angels can see. God bless you there. God
God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Please lead us back to your feet. Lead us back to your feet. Where you are. If you lift up your hand, lead us back to your feet. Just stand to your feet.
Just
pray this simple prayer with your Heavenly Father. I come to you. I'm a sinner. I can't save myself.
Sorry?
I can't change myself. But I believe you died for me. Jesus, come into my heart. Come into my life. Be my Lord and Savior. I give you my life. I give you my heart. From today, I pledge to serve you. I pledge to live for you for the rest of my life. Amen. Father, I pray for these ones and bless them. May your power uphold them, strengthen them, and help them to serve you. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. Please.